So, you know what UV mapping is, but you don't know how to do it. You know you need seams in order to control your map, but you're not sure what seams are or how they work. Not a problem. In the next 3 minutes, you will know everything you need to start placing your seams like a pro. Alright, let's do this. In order to control how the UV map is laid out, you have to put your seams in the right places. So what are seams? All you need to know is that a seam separates two faces. That is all they do, that is all they ever will do. And the best way to understand what that means is by looking at this beautiful object called a cylinder. Now cylinders are great because they clearly demonstrate seams better than any other object. Now Blender will automatically try its best to make a map even if you haven't marked your seams. Now, look what happens if we mark all the edges on the top as a seam. See that? Blender just exiled the whole thing off the island. Now why is that? Well, when we marked a seam here, it told Blender that this face and this face are not allowed to be next to each other on the map. Because we did that all around the top, Blender was like, okay. So if none of these faces are allowed to neighbor this face, then separate the whole thing, which is exactly what happened. So if we go to the backside and do the same thing, you can see that again, Blender has exiled the bottom away from the main body, leaving us with this weird spiral loop thing. Now, if you see this kind of crazy monster on your map, it means that you have forgotten about the second rule of seaming. Remember, seaming is a two-way road. A seam between two adjacent faces means that they will be separated on the map. But that also means that any two neighboring faces without a seam in between needs to be next to each other on the map. We didn't mark any seams on the body, so Blender doesn't know where to begin or end the map. The easy way to fix this is to make a seam down the middle going from one side to the other. And look at that, we have a nice organized chunk for the body and two separate maps for the front and the back. You can see how Blender gets this image from marking seams here, here, and here. But look what happens if I delete a single seam right here. See that? Because there's no seam anymore, Blender tried to reorganize the map so that all of these faces are still separated from this face, but now tried to connect these two faces. And if I delete another seam right next to it, you can see that Blender again has tried to reorganize everything, but this time while connecting the faces here and here. And it will continue to try and work this way as we add or delete seams to this object. If we look back at our pyramid, you can see that I got the shape of this UV by putting four seams on the corners. Here, 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 and here. Because there are no seams around the bottom, Blender assumed that when drawing the UV, none of these faces can be drawn next to each other, but all four faces need to be next to the bottom. The way it decided to achieve that was by organizing the map in a star like this. And that is how we get this shape. If you join me next tutorial, I will teach you where to click and what hotkeys to press in order to control and create seams so that you can start laying out your UV map in Blender 2.8. Hope that helps. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please don't forget to like and subscribe. Hope you have a fantastic day, and I'll see you around.